So here we're going to talk about the difference between service and ultimate loads with this example of a simply supported beam with two equal point loads that we'll consider live load. So you can see the dimensions and A and B here. So if we look at the first thing that we would need is we would need our reactions. So if we look at our reactions due to live loads, we would be half of 2 times our load PL, which is just going to be 1 of our PLs. If we look at our reaction due to our dead load or self weight, we'll have half of our total length, 30 feet, times the load, 0.5 kips per foot. And this will give us a load of 7.5 kips. So then we can draw our shear diagrams due to our live load and our dead load separately. And we'll start by doing them unfactored. So first, due to our dead load, so we'll go up our 7.5 kips. We'll have a slope equal to our distributed load self weight down to negative 7.5 kips. And this is, once again, our shear sub dead load. So next, we can do our shear diagram due to our live load point loads. So V sub L. So we'll go up 4 kips, our reaction. There's no applied load until we get to our first PL, down 4 kips. Come over to our next load, down 4 kips, and over. And this is our negative 4 kips. Alright, so next we can sum these and either get our service load or our ultimate load. So if we're looking for our service load, V sub S, our service load is just going to be our dead load plus our live load without any factors. So if we were to draw our diagram for our service load, we'll go up a distance equal to each of our supports or the reaction of the right support due to our self weight and our live load. We'll have a slope equal to our self weight, go down equal to the point load, slope, down, slope, and then we're back up. And our value here would be just the 7.5 plus the 4, so we would have an 11.5 kips, and a negative 11.5 kips. So our ultimate shear then would be 1.2 times our dead load plus 1.6 times our live load. So in our case, it's going to be the 1.2 times our dead load, which is 7.5 kips, plus our 1.6 times our live load, which is 4 kips. And we can run the numbers here, and we'll get a value of 15.4 kips. So we can do the same thing with our moment and torsion loads that we may have. So same procedure for our service moment, our ultimate moment, or our torsions, or also our axial loads.